Hello everyone, welcome back to Mona Patil Tutorials. Today we are going to learn about animal classification. This is part 2 of this lesson, so let's start. In last part of this chapter, that is part 1st, we learn about criteria for classification, history of animal classification and conventional system of animal classification. So, watch the part first completely, and after watching first part, watch the second part. Because all basic of this chapter are in part first. If you have not watched part 1, it will be difficult for you to understand part 2. So, watch part 1 first. Phylum Porifera. These animals are with simplest body plan and are called as sponges. They bear numerous pores on their body. Those pores are called as ostia and oscula. These are aquatic animals. Most of them are marine and few are freshwater dwellers. Okay? Most of the animals have a symmetrical body. These animals have special type of sail collar sail. These animals are always attached to substratum, hence do not show any locomotion. Hence they are referred as sedimentary animals. Their spongy body is supported by spicules or spongin fiber. Spicules are made up of calcium carbonate or cilia. These animals feed upon small organisms taken in their body along with water. Water is taken through ostia and given out through oscula. So here in the diagram you can see this is the osculum and the small pores over all the body is called as ostia. These animals reproduce by budding and asexual method and or bisexual method. Besides, they have good ability of regeneration. Okay. Then, their examples are cycon, eospongia means bath sponge, hylomnema, Hylonema, Euplectella, etc. Phylum, next phylum is Cnidaria or Cnidaria. Body of this animal is cylindrical or umbrella-like. If it is cylindrical, it is called polyp. Here, the example of Hydra, we can see their body is cylindrical shape and called as polyp. Here down the this, some animals have umbrella-like structure. Okay? And this is called medusa. So most of these animals are marine, only few are freshwater dwellers. Body of this animals is radially symmetrical and diploblastic. Okay, these two criteria we already have studied in previous video. Body of this animal is radially symmetrical and diploblastic. Cnidoblast bearing the tentacles are present around the mouth. Tentacles are useful for capturing the prey, whereas cnidoblast inject the toxin in the body of prey. Those are useful for protection too. The examples here, Hydra, Admasia means sea animal, Physalia means Portuguese man of war, and Aurelia means jellyfish and some corals, etc. Next is the phylum Platyhelminthes. Okay. Here, the name itself tells that plate means a flat body parts. So body of this animal is slender and flat like a leaf like or strip. Hence they are called as flatworms. Most of these animals are endoparasites, means they are parasite living in others' organism body. Few are free living and aquatic. Body is oscillate and bilaterally symmetrical. These are triploblasty, that is, their body is made up of three germ layers, endoderm, ectoderm and mesoderm. These animals are hermaphrodites. Hermaphrodite means the male and female reproductive system are present in the same animal body. For example, planaria, liver fluke, tapeworm, etc. This animal diagrams is also shown here. The next phylum is Ascalminthes. Here body of this animals is long thread like or cylindrical. Hence they are called as round worms. These animals are either free living or endoparasites. Free living animals are either aquatic or terrestrial. Body of this animal is triploblastic and pseudocoelomate. Body of this animal is non-segmented and covered with tough cuticle. These animals are unisexual. Examples: Ascaris means internal or intestinal worm, filarial worm, Laolo means eye worm, etc. The next phylum is Annelida. Body of this animal is long, cylindrical and metamerically segmented. Most of the animals are free living, but few are ectoparasites. Free living animals may be marine or freshwater dwellers or terrestrial. These animals are triploblastic, bilaterally symmetrical and eucoelomate. They have setae or parapodia or sucker for locomotion. Their body is covered with special cuticle. These animals are either hermaphrodites or unisexual. Examples: earthworm, leech, nares. Next phylum is Arthropoda. These animals have jointed appendages. Appendages means their legs are jointed. Hence they are called as Arthropoda. Planet Earth has highest number of animals from this phylum. Hence, this is largest phylum with highly successful animal in animal kingdom. These animals are found in all type of habitats, ranging from deepest ocean to highest mountains. Body of this animal is triploblastic, eucoelomate, bilaterally symmetrical and segmented. Next, chitinous exoskeleton is present around their body, which is hard. These animals are unisexual. Examples: crab, spider, scorpion, millipedes, centipedes, cockroach, butterfly, honeybee, etc. Next phylum is Mollusca. Body of this animal is soft and slimy. Hence they are referred as mollusk. Mollusk means soft. This is second largest phylum in animal kingdom. These animals are aquatic or terrestrial. Most of the aquatic mollusks are marine. but few are freshwater dwellers too. Body of this animal is triploblastic, eucelomate, non-segmented and soft. Except animal like snail, their body shows bilateral symmetry. Their body is divided into three divisions like head, foot and soft part is called as visceral mass. Visceral mass is covered with a mantle. This mantle secretes a hard calcareous shell. This shell may be external or internal or even absent in some case. It is external in snail and internal in octopus. These animals are unisexual. Examples: bivalve, snail, octopus, etc. Next is Echinodermata, phylum Echinodermata. Calcareous spines are present on the body of these animals. Hence, they are called as echinoderms. These animals are found only in ocean. Their body is triploblastic, eucelomate, and it is radially symmetrical in adult stage. Means adult stage means when all the growth is completed. However, they show bilateral symmetry in larval stage. They perform locomotion with the help of 2 feet. 2 feet are also useful for capturing the prey. Some animals are sedentary, means they cannot be locomote. They have skeleton made up of calcareous spine and or ossicles, means plates. These animals have good ability of regeneration, means their cut part or the part which can cut apart from body can be grow into a new individual. These animals are mostly unisexual. Examples: starfish, sea urchin, sea cucumber, etc. Next phylum is Hemichordata. Body of these animals is divided into 3 parts as a proboscis, collar and trunk. Notochord is present in proboscis region only. Hence, they are called as hemichordates. These animals are also called as acorn worm. These are marine animals live in burrow in sand. They have 1 to many pharyngeal gill slit. They are unisexual or some may be hermaphrodites. Example, balanoglossus or sacculoglossus. Next phylum is Chordata. Here these animals have supporting notochords in their body. All chordates are included in the same phylum. The phylum chordate is classified into 3 subphylum like Urochordata, Vertebrata and Cephalochordata. Okay? So here we will stop. Phylum Chordata. These animals have supporting notochords in their body. All chordates are included in the same phylum. The phylum Chordata is classified into 3 subphylum. So here following are important characters of phylum Chordata. First, notochord is present in the body during at least any developmental stage. Pharyngeal gill slit are present in the body during at least any developmental stage. Third one, single tubular spinal cord is present on the dorsal side of body. And fourth one, heart is present on ventral side of body. So one by one we'll see first subphylum, that is Urochordates. These are marine animals. Their body is covered by skin like vest or tunic. Larvae of this animal are freely swimming and notochords is present in only tail region of larvae. Hence they are called as urochords. Larvae metamorphose into adult after setting down at bottom of the sea. Generally, these animals are hermaphrodites. Examples: Harmonia, Dolium, Oikopleura, etc. Then next subphylum is Cephalochordate. These animals are small fish-like marine animal. Notochord is present throughout the body length. Pharynx is very large and contain gill slit. Okay, in diagram you can see here, this is the pharyngeal gill, which is long and containing gill slit. These animals are unisexual. An example is Amphioxus. Subphylum Vertebrata or Craniata. In this animal, notochord is replaced by vertebral column. Sorry. In this animal, notochord is replaced by vertebral column. In these animals, head is well developed, brain is protected by cranium, endoskeleton is either cartilaginous or bony. Some chordates are jawless. It is also known as agnatha. Whereas some are with jaw, means gnathostomata. Here, this subphylum Vertebrata is again divided into six classes. Okay, so one by one we will see. The first class is Cyclostomata. Cyclo means circular and stomata means mouth. Okay, so you can consider their mouth is circular and having a sucker. Okay. So, these animals have jawless mouth provided with sucker. Their skin is soft and without any scale. Paired appendages are absent. Endoskeleton is cartilaginous. Cartilaginous means they contain soft bone. Most of the animals are ectoparasites. Here, example, Petromyzon and myxin, etc. Next class, Pisces, means all fish are included in this class. These are cold-blooded or poikilotherms aquatic animal living in marine and fresh water. Body is spindle-shaped to minimize the water resistance. Spindle shape means in both the end it become acute. Okay. To minimize the water resistance. They have paired and unpaired fin for swimming. Tail fin is useful as a steering organ during swimming. So it can be easy to change the direction while swimming. Exoskeleton is in the form of scales and endoskeleton is either cartilaginous or bony. Respiration occurs with gill. Examples: Rohu, Pomfret, Seahorse, Shark, Electric Ray, Stingray, etc. Next class is the Amphibia. These animals are strictly aquatic during larval life and perform only aquatic respiration. Whereas they can live in water as well as on land during adult life and can perform aquatic as well as aerial respiration. They have two pair of appendages. Digits are without claws. Exoskeleton is absent. Skin is without any derivatives and usually kept moist for respiration. External ear is absent, but tympanum is present. Neck is absent. Eyes are prominent with eyelid. Okay, and here examples are frog, toad, salamander, etc. The next class is the reptilia. So, according to course of animal evolution, these are first true terrestrial animal with creeping movement. These are cold-blooded or poikilotherms animal. They creep on the land as their body cannot be lifted up. Their skin is dry and scaly. Neck is present between head and trunk. External ear is absent. Digits are provided with the claws. For example, tortoise, lizard, snake, etc. Then next class is aves. Means all the birds are included in this class. These vertebrates are completely adapted for aerial life. These are warm-blooded or homeotherm. That is, they can maintain their body temperature constant. Their body is spindle-shaped to minimize air resistance during flight. Forelimbs are modified into wings. Digits are covered with a scale and bear claws. Exoskeleton is present in the form of feather. Neck is present between head and trunk. Jaws are modified into beak. And the examples are peacock, parrot, pigeon, dove, penguin, etc. Then last class is the mammalia that we also include in this class. So, here presence of mammary glands is the typical characters of mammalia. These animals are warm-blooded. Body is divided into head, neck, trunk and tail. Digits are provided with nails, claws or hooves in mammalia. So, exoskeleton is in the form of hair and fur. Examples: elephant, human, kangaroo, dolphin, bat, etc.
Thank you for watching this video. If you like my video, then press on the like button. If you have any problems regarding the lesson, you can ask me in comment section. We will meet in the next video. Till then, bye bye.